Gentlemen, the next contest on Nitro is for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship, set for one fall. Introducing first the challenger from Tsunami, weighing over 500 pounds.
This guy has got his work cut out for him. The Shark, a big man, but the Giant, so powerful, not only possesses the weight, 450 plus pounds, he has got the height, the leverage, the athletic ability to make him not only a mountain among men, but quite possibly the most superior athlete of his size in the history of our sport.
I suggest you get on the phone right now and call anybody you know and tell them that this may be the first time in history you're ever gonna see the Giant defend his title against a man that outweighs him. Shark outweighs this man. But this man packs the gold. He's a heavyweight champion of the world. He's WCW champion. Shark's gonna have his work cut out for him.
Well, another man who is gonna have his work cut out for him is Lex Luger, a man who backed in, so to speak, to a shot at the world heavyweight title thanks to the conspicuous antics of one Diamond Dallas Page, who won the Lord of the Ring contest, however, will not, I repeat, will not get a shot at the title. That title shot awarded to one Lex Luger. But, you know, that brings up an interesting proposition here. What about Jimmy Hart? That puts him, he's a man in the middle. He's got Luger, he's got the Giant.
Well, I don't know if he really does have Luger. If you remember, they were handcuffed to each other. And something happened with that megaphone with the Stinger last time there. Luger gets the shot. I don't think Luger wanted Sting to win that match. I think he wanted to go in the back door like he did. Smart move on his part.
Well, we are into it here, and a lot of, well, we won't call it hate, we'll just call it resentment. A grudge match, if you will. The Shark, a man who thought that he was, well, he resided comfortably in the Dungeon of Doom, found out that the depths of their dirty work can go real deep. And the Shark on the receiving end of a chokeslam from that man. And he's hot. You heard the interview.
Well, there's almost a ton of human being in that ring right there. Well over 1,000 pounds. That man's over 500 pounds. The Giant, the champion, close to 500 pounds, and they don't like each other.
No, they don't at all. Of course, we've seen the Shark and Big Bubba together in more places than one recently, but obviously no love lost between these two, and the big man is off his feet. 500 pounds, goes off his feet like a 180-pound man. This is incredible.
Look, he's standing on the Shark like he's standing on a curb. I'll tell you what can happen here. A couple things can happen. Shark can come out of this as the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, or he can be mounted over the mantelpiece of the Giant's house like a big fish, or he can go to Mrs. Paul's and be fish sticks.
And you see that boot right across the throat. That's one heck of a lot of fish sticks, by the way, Heenan.
That's a few packages you have to put in the deep fryer.
The Shark now going after the Giant. Double sledge behind the head. The Giant weathers the storm. Takes two big clubbing forearms, three forearms from this 500-pound monster. And now the Giant, probably only one of the only men in WCW that can try to manhandle this.
Yes.
Look at this! Look at
my goodness!
Power!
That man is well over 500 pounds, Bischoff. He's gonna tip the Toledos at a good 525, 530, and the Giant picked him up like he was picking up a grain of.
I'll tell you what, Heenan, I was just about to say, I'll eat this desk if the Giant can pick him up and body slam him. He not only picked him up and slammed him, he didn't even break a sweat in the process.
And he turned him. He didn't get him up there. He didn't bend his knees. He didn't have any trouble. He muscled him up from the waist up, which is sheer power. That is why this man right there, the Giant, is the WCW Heavyweight Champion.
Lex Luger, what are you going to do at the Great American Bash? What kind of strategy could you possibly employ to try to defeat this man?
Well, if you remember, Bischoff, just a couple weeks back, the Giant took Lex Luger by the throat, knocked over the candelabras, the champagne, the ice buckets, and picked Lex Luger up and jammed him right through a table. And Luger swore that would never happen again. He says, the next time I get in the ring with that man, I'm walking out the champion.
And now, the Shark gouging the eyes, digging into the face of the world heavyweight champion, the Giant, a man who you can be sure the great Hulk Hogan is watching closely. Hulk Hogan, we saw a quick look at him a little earlier. You can bet the Hulkster looking on at everything that's going on here tonight. in this inaugural two-hour broadcast of WCW Monday Nitro Live on TNT, and we'll be coming to you each and every week from this point forward. The first hour at 8 o'clock, the second hour starting approximately at 8:50 each and every week here on TNT.
And it gets hotter. The second hour, you have to wear asbestos. Look at this. Look at this.
Look at that! Oh! Big boot comes up, 500 pounds, ready to launch off the middle turnbuckle. Will he take him off his feet? He does, but barely. And now the Shark redeeming himself, getting his just desserts, and I mean desserts.
Jimmy knows what he's doing here. Jimmy sacrificed himself for the Giant. What a great combination there.
No. Shark slam.
Oh. He not only body slammed him, he picked him up with one hand, stuck him like a thumbtack, and got the three count.
Boy, did he ever. There he is, the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World. Pick that man up.
What's Bubba doing in here? What's he doing? They're gonna cut his hair.
Oh no.
They're cutting his hair off.
The Dungeon of Doom is tattooing this man. The Dungeon of Doom are leaving his mark. Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, believe me, has sent Bubba in there, the new Bubba in there, to disgrace and dishonor the man Shark, the man he fired.
Look at this, they're shaving his head. And it looks to me like they're not even shaving, they're shaving half his head.
Well, it doesn't really matter with that head. You just shave as much as you can. Things like a Brunswick bowling ball.
They are shaving his head. This is a disgrace. This is the most disgraceful thing that one wrestler can do to another.
And it's, what they should do is not shave his head. That's a disgrace. They should just pull the hair out in lumps. That's what I'd do if I was in the position that they have to be in. They're sending a message. Look at that. Half his hair cut.